Alright, so we're heading out to one of my favorite spots. We have access to a small piece of private land just outside of Duluth, Minnesota. We've had good luck here last year. We took a handful of doe out of here and even doubled up one night. Seen some good bucks out here last year. Two in particular that I would like to see again and shoot either one of them, actually. But there's one particular deer that I would really like to get a shot at. It's one I got on my camera earlier this year. We didn't get a very good picture of him, but what I do know is he's big. And we call him the Club because of the picture. It's a hard picture to look at, but I'll show it on here in a moment. But off his, be his left side, it is like a big massive club coming off the top. And the right hand side, you really can't see what's on it, but it looks a little funky. But I mean, I like deer that have a lot of character, but it would be really cool to see him up close if we get the chance. Yeah, so we're going to sit here. It's probably close to 2:30 right now. It gets dark around 7:30. So we should hopefully have some good action tonight. So stick around, we'll see what happens. Alright, so we just got here. Like I said, we have a little piece of property, 40 acres. Hopefully gonna try and take some doe out of it today. Yeah, it's real warm out, so I don't know how much deer movement we're gonna have, but we've had good luck here in the past, warm, cold. The doe seem to transition through here pretty regularly, so it doesn't seem to really matter from past experience out here, but yeah, stick with us. Alright, well, we just got set up. This spot in particular is a spot I call the Killbox because we're inside an Ameristep blind right now. It's one of the hub style blinds, the first year I've hunted out of it. Last year I had a little doghouse blind that was a little small for archery hunting, but it worked out okay. But so we just got set up and here we got my my mission bow. Like I said, we've killed some deer out here last year. See what happens. Something behind you or just out of range or behind a back in the patch of thicket, you know. That's how it goes. We're gonna stick it out. Hopefully we can put an arrow on a door. If we can even get lucky, a club will come by.
Well, we didn't get him today, but we'll be back out here Wednesday. Some stuff I have to take care of tonight. I can't stay out much longer, and the landowner, I'm sure you can hear, it's doing some work on his trails, running chainsaws. Right now you can hear his four-wheeler running over there and his tractor, so figured call quits, get some stuff done. We'll be back out here Wednesday. Yep. All right, well, we just got back to the property that has the Killbox on it. We just took a ride with the landowner, Roger. We took a ride. He has one of those Polaris Ranger 4x4s, and it's got some brand new trails cut that he cut this winter going on a totally other end of the property that I've never been to before. And so we went on a ride to kind of go look around, and there's a nice big oak ridge over there. So hopefully when these leaves start falling, I'll get out there and put a stand up in there. But it's so thick right now back there that time's better spent hunting the early season doe patterns. So hopefully come October, I'm gonna set a setup in there and hunt last weekend in October, some November hunts back in there, so should be pretty good. But as today we're in the kill box again, gonna grab the bow, grab the camera tripod, and we're gonna get after it.
Welcome to the home of the hillbilly. Yeah, baby, it's a land of barbed wire and moonshine whiskey. Park your car before you get stuck. Go and grab you a beer and get on up in the truck. It's going down tonight. It's all on me, it's BYOB, and I got all we need. Yeah, boy, I'm about to show me a city slicker how to kick it in the sticks with the critters down on the side of the barbed wire. Money grows and rolls, if it don't, you're going broke. So we hang out by the bonfire. Just a good old boys having a dang good time. We crank it up, we get loud. We're throwing down in the dirty, dirty south down here. Being all nighter with the hippies and the hicks. Jocks and bikers, they all came to kick it in the sticks. Drop a tailgate, yeah, we're cracking up ACDC.
Wow, that's low.
It really is low.
And it, if you can imagine, none of this rock here that we're all looking at was here before the big flood.
Really?
All came down from the flood.
Last summer?
Last summer, yeah.
Wow, what was it before? Just all gravel and sand?
It was kind of sandish, yeah. And right where this little rock is here, that was the edge of the river. Now the river's all moved over, you know?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, quite a bit.
We just got back out to the kill box. We sat here Monday. Didn't have much luck. But it's Wednesday. I believe it's the 18th. But yeah, we just got set up. We've got a few hours, about three and a half hours, before it just started getting darker. It's raining outside a little bit. It's kind of misting, sprinkling off and on. It's not raining too hard, so the deer should still be moving to stay warm. But yeah, hopefully we can get it done. It's about 6 o'clock, and I don't know if you can hear it or not, but it's still raining pretty good out. It'll come in spurts, but I won't be able to get out again for a few days, so we're going to sit, and we're going to wait on a deer. Hopefully, one will come by, and we didn't sit out here in the rain, in the cold, for nothing. So, I'll be here.
She's not a big doe. She's a doe.
There she is, right there. Come on, where is she? There she is. There she is, boys.
Not a big doe, but she'll do. You know, she didn't have a mother doe with her, so only if there's a mother doe around, I won't take ones this small. But it's been a rough season. Don't have anything on the ground yet. Haven't filled a doe tag, so thankful she came by. She's gonna be dinner. So, awesome. I'm happy with it.